I just need to hear more about Ozempic. How do I hear more about Ozempic?
Find out today on Medical History Mysteries.
Welcome to Medical History Mysteries. I'm Dr. Pam Maragliano-Muniz. With me, as always, Dr. Tom Viola. Hey.
How's everything going, Pam?
Everything's great. So you really riveted me last week when we talked about Ozempic and what it is and where it comes from and how it's a hormone that we actually have in our own bodies. And this just sort of is an agonist for it sort of thing. Mm-hmm. Now, great overview. But as a dental professional, what happens when I have a patient that sits down in my chair and they have listed Ozempic as one of the medications that they take?
So you know what I'm going to say next. I always say the same, right? It's the three questions. What do you take? Why do you take it? And did you take it today? So what do you take? Ozempic. Why do you take it? That's got to be the question you ask next, because I don't know if you're using it for type 2 diabetes, weight loss. I'm not really sure. And I need to know those things, right, to get more about it. So if you're using it for diabetes, well, then I've got a whole litany of questions to ask you after that. Like, how do you manage your diabetes? You know, what was your latest A1C? What was your latest blood glucose? And of course, I'm going to be looking for signs of diabetes and uncontrolled diabetes that would have manifestations in your oral cavity. But if I didn't ask the question, I might go down that road for quite a while only to find out, hey, I'm not using Ozempic because I have diabetes. I'm using Ozempic because I want to lose some weight. So first off, it's a matter of discovery to find out why. But realizing no matter why they use it, there are some dental considerations for the use of the drug Ozempic and drugs like it in the same class that need to be addressed. And one of the first things is, well, I've lost some weight now. How much weight? Well, a considerable amount of weight. Okay, do I now need to modify the dosages of things like local anesthetics? Do I need to modify the dosages of antibacterial agents and maybe even analgesics that I would normally use in you, especially if you've achieved a significant weight loss? Number two, using it for obesity. I'm concerned because this drug was originally designed to treat type 2 diabetes. Are you a risk for something like hypoglycemia? Hate to say this, Pam, you know, I try to think the best of our patients and people, but if I knew I was taking this drug to lose weight, and I'm not really under the care of a doctor, I bought it black market, I got it from my relative, I got it from my friend or my family member. As simplistic as it sounds, if I use this much Ozempic to lose this much weight, well, then maybe I want to lose this much weight, I should use this much Ozempic. More is better, right? But now I open myself up to things like hypoglycemia, especially in a stressful situation. And if you ask most patients, you know, what's one of the most stressful situations they can find themselves, they're going to say what? In your chair, right? So would they be ready for it? Would I even think to ask about hypoglycemia? Would I even think about hypoglycemic reactions in a patient who uses Ozempic when they've stated specifically to use it for weight loss? I guess I'd have to, right? Because no matter what they use it for, it's the same drug. And then I'd be worried about something like pancreatitis. Pancreatitis is insidious. You may not even know you have it. It really sometimes manifests as just a pain in your stomach. Well, if I'm losing weight with Ozempic and I'm experiencing some of that shrinkage of my stomach, I may not think twice about it. And honestly, that ache in your stomach makes you not hungry. So hey, so much the better. If I'm not an expert on how Ozempic works and what it does, I might think that's normal. But it really is pancreatitis. So this is, again, why dental professionals save lives, right? We save people from themselves, because sometimes, even though they're great people and smart in their own right, they don't necessarily make the best medical decisions for themselves.
At the end of the day, it is a diabetic drug. The weight loss aspect of it is a side effect. So if you're taking it for weight loss, you're still taking a diabetic drug, and I would imagine it's still going to have that impact. You know, so if you're, say, an otherwise healthy person, you're now almost throwing off, right, your own insulin levels or your own sugar levels or something like that, just to achieve this desired result.
Agreed. And of course, you know, there has been some link, mostly with Victoza, to thyroid cell tumors. And so again, since we're heavily involved sometimes, not just dentists, but also hygienists in, you know, palpating the thyroid and doing a thyroid exam, you know, this is something that may come up as well. If you're using Ozempic, I want to maybe pay closer attention to your thyroid to see if perhaps there's, you know, something else going on that may require you to seek medical attention. Again, this is how we save lives in dentistry. You know, we get all the information, we adapt, improvise, and overcome, to borrow from the Marines, okay? We look to see what we can do to modify our treatment protocols and modify our treatments for each individual patient to be able to give them not only the best dental care, but the best overall care, even if it involves their systemic health.
So that would be another reason to keep your little sugar pack handy in case somebody has a hypoglycemic attack secondary to Ozempic use.
Yep. I always like, you know, glucagon to be in the emergency kit for the treatment of hypoglycemia in patients who are unconscious or barely conscious. I like the use of glucose gel, you know, to be available because glucose is easy to use. But heck, I'd be okay with sucrose, like a sugar packet, if anything, just to make sure I've got something immediately and readily available. And let's face it, if you're diabetic, type 2 diabetic, and you've used Ozempic before, and or you've used other medications before, and you've experienced hypoglycemia, you know what to expect. You've had it before. But if I'm a relatively new user of Ozempic for weight loss, I've never experienced hypoglycemia, I wouldn't know what to say. I wouldn't know what's happening to me. So another reason for us to be the advocate for our patients when they don't necessarily make the best choices for themselves.
Wow. Or even if they are doing it under a doctor's supervision, you know, they might not realize, especially if you have a long appointment or they didn't eat or something like that. We know that, you know, we have a really, really significant role in keeping them safe and healthy. So these were exceptional tips. Thank you for that.
Happy to oblige. Thank you, everybody, for joining us for Medical History Mysteries today.
All right, everyone. We will see you next week. Bye.
Bye, buddy.